What's up, everyone? Welcome back. I am... Something's acted weird in my camera, so hopefully everyone can hear me and see me. I need to check first and make sure that everything's working properly. Just a real quick check. Alright, perfect. So, today I'm going to be streaming a little bit of Final Fantasy XIV for a little while. And then after that, I might switch over to some Skyrim. I've been meaning to play some. Just haven't quite... not feeling it right now. I want to do some Final Fantasy XIV stuff. I've been trying, after the fan festival, it's been on my mind a lot. There's lots of stuff I need to figure out and lots of stuff I didn't know about. So we're going to try and figure some new stuff out, like getting a house in a residential area. That should be on the list. I have a list. I forget stuff. I forget what I'm doing sometimes. So I like to remind myself. Alright, so... oh, let's see. What do I want to do? Ooh, so much to do. Oh, this song. Susan Calloway performed this live. At the fan festival. I haven't watched the opening video in a while, so... I really need to do some reading up on the lore. Like, I need to spend one full day reading all about this stuff. Something about different heavens, I don't know. It's always good to have a nice intro video. I don't remember the song being played though last time. Maybe I wasn't paying attention. That was my city. I know, they're amazing, aren't they? All right, nothing like a good opening video to give everybody time to jump in on the broadcast and I don't know, ramp up spirits a little bit. Why, right? It's always a beautiful open video. Okay, so I might be slurring a little bit here. That's all right. One of those days. Today, what should we do today? I'm gonna go play some Gold Saucer games because I have yet to actually check it out. Well, maybe. It depends on how far away I am from everything. Let's make sure we can get back here easily first, huh? Set home point. Cool. Home point is set. Do-do-do-do-do. Alright, why not? Mini game time! Alright, now I've just gotta get on board the airship and head towards the Golden Saucer. Hope everybody's doing alright on this fabulous Sunday. I have another day off, which is wonderful. And it's a day to recover. I might do take some naps and get some sleep. Oh, look, I have mail. That might be my reward. Since I did the streaming thing, Okay, just making sure that's working. Since I did the streaming thing for Final Fantasy XIV Fan Festival, I was given rewards for watching, for participating, for being part of the scenes. For be a part of the action. Alright, trying to figure this out. See what kind of little side games we got here. Hopefully. Alright. Hello. Well, aren't you a handsome one? Welcome to Card Square, home of the Triple Triad tables. What's Triple Triad, you ask? Why, the mind-bending, pulse-pounding, maddeningly Moorish card game that's taken the realm by storm. But don't take my word for it. Behold. Oh, I don't like card games. We're gonna go do something else. I'm sure there are other people that like card games, but I'm not one of them. Welcome! Okay, sure, mini cackpot. Playing is simplicity itself. Just guess the value of covered numbers to win it big. If Nimella's Grace is with you, you'll be rewarded with Manderville Gold Saucer points. So, you feel lucky? Now purchase up to 3 mini cackpot tickets per day. Cackpot for mini cackpot tickets resets daily at 10 a.m. Earth time. Each mini cackpot ticket has 9 slots arranged in 3x3 grid. Each slot is randomly assigned a number from 1 to 9. When you purchase a ticket, a single number will be revealed. Play, uncover any 3 numbers. Based on the information, guess the sum of each line. Finally, select a single line. Payout for MGP will depend on the total sum of the line you have chosen. Okay. Salutations. Would you care to purchase the latest copy of Aesthetician Stilanodabana? Contains a collection of styles based on opinions and preferences. No, I'm good. No. Okay. Gatekeeper, huh? Okay. You look lost, honey. Why don't I show you around? I've been dying for some company. Uh-oh. Feast your eyes on Wonder Square. From gripping games and awe-inspiring attractions to the finest in fine dining and the freshest of refreshments, so there's no end to the wonders housed within these halls. Let's not forget the most wondrous of them all, El Coloso, as we lovingly call our mammoth cactar mascot, is the star of some of our most popular events. Suffice it to say, you won't want to miss them. Now, I know what you're thinking. With everything going on at Gold Saucer, how can I ever hope to keep up? But you needn't worry, my fellow. Gatekeepers and I will always be on hand to see that you don't miss a thing. For the continuation of your tour, I've been instructed to direct you into the waiting arms of my colleague, Valeta. Keck Park, Lord. Most popular girls. Once you meet her, I'm sure you'll understand well. Ta-ta for now. Okay. You guys are just sending me on missions. If you want to do missions, you can be able to fancy your bird the fleetest in their own. Registers. Chocobo is ever accepting registrations for new race chocobos. Okay. That's what I want to do too. I like to read. I'm gonna see if how this whole chocobo racing thing goes. Sounds pretty cool. I guess I go up this way. Oh no, that was the wrong way. Just going in circles. That's where I need to go. Greetings, handsome. I've been waiting for you. I'm Velda. I'm Velita. And I'd like to personally welcome you to Event Square. Alright, wonderful. The most spacious of all the areas of the Gold Saucer Event Square. Hold on a second, guys. I'm gonna do something just because I wanna do something. Let's see, here we go. Oh. This is the scene of some of our most sensational attractions, so don't be shy by taking center stage. And after the curtain has fallen, why not try changing your life forever at the Jumbo Cackpot? All you need is a handful of MGP and a head full of dreams. Just choose four numbers and cast your hopes to the heavens. You never know just when Nemea will smile down upon you. Now, as much as I've enjoyed getting to know you, I'm afraid it's time for us to depart. Next and final leg of your takes. You two round square. Don't think too hard about the name, darling. Even I'm not sure it's supposed to make sense. Sorry, spaced out there for a minute, guys. Welcome to Cagmar. Where is Eorzea of your dreams? Where the Eorzea of your dreams is only four digits away. Can I attempt you with a ticket, sir? Okay. Ah, there was the other one. Okay, cool. Oh, nope, not going down yet. Go around this way, I guess. Yeah, okay. There's the gatekeeper. Are you the first timer visitor? I was told to expect 1,000 welcomes to the Gold Saucer and 1,000 welcomes to Round Square. How can a square be round, you ask? I'm not sure I understand the question. Moving on to the important matters, is that lofty peak a sight to behold? That is Mount Coral, the main attraction here at Round Square. One of our most thrilling events pits our customers against each other in the challenge to see who can most swiftly scale its heights. I tell you, the view from the summit is a sight to behold. And that concludes your tour of the Gold Saucer. While I'm sure you're eager to start enjoying yourself, pray do not forget to return to the main concert and claim your complimentary gift. Okay, I get a gift. I like gifts. Can I go up to the top of this thing? There's gotta be a way up. Or is it only for... Yes, it's only for competitors. Alright, fine. Free gift! I like gifts! Give me free stuff! Welcome back, honored guest. I trust that you've come away from your tour with a greater appreciation of all the Gold Saucer has to offer. As a token of our appreciation for your patronage, it is my pleasure to offer you a complimentary gift from the personal vaults of our esteemed proprietor. Well, knock me down with a chocobo's tail feather. Is that a new customer I see? Ha ha! I could hardly have picked a better time to drop in for an impromptu inspection. Master Roland, yes, this gentleman here has but this moment completed his introductory tour. Is that so? Well then, allow me to personally welcome you to the Gold Saucer. I am Roland, good sir, the fellow entrusted with overseeing the daily affairs of this fine establishment on behalf of our esteemed proprietor, a great man if ever there was one. You are an adventurer, yes? Aye, your dress and bearing told me as much. I dare say that that on your travels, you have been first-hand to the difficulties which yet plague our nation. witness the struggles of Alamigos, displaced masses, and those whose homes were consumed in fires of the calamity. Alamigo is actually going to be the next expansion. It's the one that's coming in the summer of 2017 that they did the premiere for at the fan festival this weekend. The Sultanate is not unsympathetic to their plight, of course, yet how can one begin to provide to such countless multitudes? One man had an answer. Godbert Manderville had a dream. A dream of a house untold wonders that would provide stable employment and lodgings to the displaced mirth and merriment. To the disconsolate and prosperity and plenty to the Sultanate at large. To many of our patrons, the Gold Saucer is merely Eorzea's foremost entertainment venue, a place to forget about or cares for the day. To me, it is one of the founding stones upon which our realm will be rebuilt, a miracle wrought by the hand of the greatest man I have ever known. Something tells me you understand that which I have told you, that you perchance, share a similar dream. But I shall keep you no longer. The Gold Saucer and all its wonders await you, friend. Pray, enjoy them to your heart's content. Till we meet again, may the Spinner's Bowl be ever kind. Tickets. I got more tickets. Okay, cool. Look at that. What's a cliffhanger? I don't know, but I better hurry. Oh, hey! Look, they're playing games! Ma said to stay away from the big statue, but Bootkins is at the top. And if I save her, who will? 50 MGP is required to assist the girl you currently possess 0, proceed? Sure! I don't have enough MGP. Okay! Well, I need to figure out how to get that. Probably be helpful. Minutes 20 seconds. Alright, now that we've got the MGP, we'll go back over here and play again. This will be my first game. Hopefully I can do something good. Maybe win some prizes. I don't know what kind of prizes I'll win, but I'm excited. Alright, here we go. That one. Give me another chance, come on. 3 minutes, 15 seconds, I can do this. Oh, there we go. Okay. This is going to be quite difficult. Oh! Hey, there you are. Hey, a black chocobo. What is that, 2000 MGP? Yep, cool. Alright, that was fun. On to the next game. Wait, I don't think I can get down. Okay. There we go. Alright, well that was cool. Let's see what else we got around here. Monster toss, all right. Why not? Play a round of monster toss for 1 MGP. You currently possess 2,000. Use one of the 5 tickets. They change it. Okay. That's cool. Alright. I suck. You got the first one, though. And that's all I got. Time's up. Okay. Let's do that again. Make at least one. There we go. Yay! Special limited time event has concluded. We look forward to your participation in events to come. Cool. Alright, well, that was fun. Alright, time to find something else. Something I'm good at. Mogul's Paw? Moogles? Moogle's Paw? Okay. Obtain 1,000 MGP. Size doesn't matter. Complete. Okay. Sure, why not? Question is, where is the chocobo racing? Oh, hugs. Okay. You look suspicious. Okay, whatever. Greetings! Our next scheduled event, Any Way the Wind Blows, will be held in Event Square. All guests are welcome. Next go. 4:45 p.m. Okay. So what, I don't do anything until then? I guess it's an entirely event-based world here. Yeah, they all say the same thing. Okay. What's this? Oh. Wait, am I supposed to go for the middle or the end? Sure, alright, I guess I go for the middle. There we go. Alright, one more time. Alright, that's enough. Oh yeah, something I forgot to tell you guys. I guess you probably should have mentioned this earlier, but who cares? There's one person watching. They will no longer support PS3 coming at the beginning of summer next year. No more PS3 support, which blows. So if I wanted to play this on my big TV, I would have to plug in my computer. Okay. Welcome to drawing number 163 of the Jumbo Cackpot. Can I interest you in a ticket to fame or and fortune? Jumbo view payout. First prize, 1 million, huh? And a mad bird ring? Selected every Saturday. This is a lottery. Okay. Nope, that's it. I'm sure they'll send me a piece of mail saying whether I won or not. There's gotta be a game in here somewhere. I think this is the only place I haven't looked. Thank you. This guy's gotta be up to something. I don't know what. Oh. It's almost 4:45 Eorzea time, but I don't know if they're talking about Eorzea time or real world time. So we'll wait here for a couple more seconds and find out for sure. Okay, that's where I was before. This is the main event. So I could go check out down here. Did the cuff thing. I haven't gone over there yet. Alright, 40. 1. 2. Alright, that should be it, right? Local time. Okay, so it's talking about real time. Alright, got it. So that's 10 minutes away, basically. Which means I'd have to hang around for another 10 minutes if I really wanted to do something. Oh, hey, here's another game. Almost. Ooh, not even close. All right, one more try. Alright, that was fun for a minute. Alright. What's up here? Oh, what'd you say? The Manderville Lounge offers a variety of specialty drinks, including wine, water, wavered wine, and Gold Saucer original wine water. But I can't buy any, can I? The day they let me sit in chairs. That would be awesome. Alright, let's see. What's next? Oh, over there. Alright. Oh, this is nothing either. Whoa! I didn't see that coming. That was pretty cool. That's awesome. Okay, enough of that. Not even sure what date it is. It is 16th. I've got 2 days to pay my phone bill. Alright, fine. You're the last quest I have here, so I might as well. I don't get it. Whatever. Now you want me to do something, huh? Any new cards you obtain will be stored in your inventory. Use a card to add it to your card list, which can be viewed from the Gold Saucer options. On your character menu. Next, select card decks, also found under Gold Saucer. Build a 5-card deck. Tries battle between two opponents, wherein the clever composition of strategic use of 5-card deck means the difference between victory and defeat. Game can be transformed by a plethora of advanced rules, which can force even experienced players to adapt and revise their seemingly invincible repertories. I don't know. Once you've mastered the basics, there's still much to learn. Building a deck. Okay, the set of 5 cards you play during a match is known as a deck. Building a dependable deck from your cards required every step defeating your rival. Oh. You must use the cards in your inventory to register them to your card deck. Your card deck must access the solution. Okay. By 3 grid. A variety of rules exist to change all open. This rule allows you to see you. There you go, I played your game. Alright, wonderful. Battle Hall unlocked. Oh no, I don't want to play again. I don't want these on my. Alright, fine, whatever. Thank you. to do anything until I beat you. Those don't go away until I beat you. Well, that blows. Alright, well, I've got 3 minutes till the main concert starts. Alright, well, we're gonna go do this. And then once this is done, it's back to the main story. Wait a second, that person looked cool. I want to know what server I'm on. How can I tell what server I'm on? Oh no, I got for 1 minute. Bleeding, but not good. Okay. Oh, wait, is it down there? There it is. Uh-oh, more people. 2 seconds. Enter the main stage, you're now closed. Those wishing to observe are welcome. Oh. He's just chilling. Okay. Alright, that was pointless. Cool. Alright, back to the main story. Alright, so what we have here is nothing. Oh no, that's my other one. Okay, this one. I'm in Central Shroud. I need to go south. Okay. Chocobo time. Yay, you're getting use. You're being used. Tokai! I never found the racing. That's what I forgot to do. Alright, well, next time. I'll have to look up more stuff on Chocobo Racing. I don't know why I forgot about it. That's okay. It's okay. I'll do it next time. Alright, back to where we need to be. Do the finish the level 23 quest first, and then move on to that one. Maybe I'll finally be done with this guy. Probably not, though. Lorientus confessed to his crimes. I just had word from the twin Aether. Seems he marched straight into the nest and gave himself up. The lad's had quite a life, you know. His mother was killed by a brigand, and when he was only small, as a young man, he joined the whalers, hoping to spare his fellow Gridanians the misery he'd known growing up. Trouble is, protecting Gridania is too big a job for one man. He came to believe that he couldn't make a difference, but it was hopeless. There are few things more dangerous than desperation, and a man lost in the darkness. Dark is easily drawn to glimmer of coin. I reckon he thought that if he couldn't change the lot of his fellow man, he might as well change his own. Thing is, he was making a difference, just not on his own. Somehow, he'd failed to grasp one simple truth, that those things we cannot do alone, we must do together. Eh? He asked to thank me? He asked you to thank me, did he? Then there's good in him yet. I just hope them at the Aether's nest are able to see it. What he's done ain't easy to forgive, but I'd like to think he'd be afforded a chance to make amends. But let us leave fates to the 12, and I have other news for you. The Sylph Elder has been found! Woohoo! And I didn't even have to do anything. That's nice. Oh, you still have another put? Okay, so where was he? Oh wait, he's been found doesn't mean... Just because he's been found doesn't mean he's safe, I suppose. It's taken us a fair old while, but we finally got our hands on some reliable information concerning the whereabouts of the missing green friend. Of your missing green friend. Oops. His name is Frixio, and he is the eldest among the sylphs of Little Solace. Long has he represented his kind in dialogue with the Gradanians. Yes, he's like a bridge between us and them, a small leafy green bridge that we can't find at the moment. And bridges are no use if you don't know where they are. That's why it's so important we find him. There's an abandoned dungeon called the Thousand Maws of Toto Rock here in the South Shroud. 'Twas by the entrance to the place that Frixia was seen not long ago, neither. If you hurry, I reckon you'll find him. Walking ones, please help us. This one needs help. Needs help to help Elder One. Poor Frixio. Poor Frixio. Whoa. Hold your chocobos. Take a deep breath and tell us what's wrong, nice and slow. Elder One went into Toto Rock, but has not returned. The one is worried. This one is worried. So worried. Ah, you're right to be. The place fair crawls with nasties, waiting to make a meal if anyone daft enough to wander in. What in the seven cells was he thinking, entering that bloody death trap? Elder One had no choice. Imperial Ones were chasing Elder One. Please! Walking Ones must help Elder One. Help Elder One now! Arr, the fates conspire against us. Forgive my pragmatism. But Frixio is our best hope of reaching an accord with these sylphs. Were we to lose him, all our efforts thus far will have been for naught. I will tend to your wounds, Yada. Make haste to the Aider's Nest and request assistance. Understood. Catastrophe. Go to 1,000 miles Toto Rock and see that Frixio comes to no harm. Peace between man and sylph rests upon your success. I made a badass character. Just talking about it makes me feel good. Okay, 1,000 miles over there. But first, we're gonna go finish the other quest on my chocobo. And I need to see, maybe this place has a mailbox. Levin-Made at Quarmel's recruiting adventurers to undertake his stack of local quests. I guess so. I don't feel like doing these right now. I'm not even sure what the purpose of them are, but I guess we'll figure it out later. Alright, well, I guess it's a little north. Chocobo! Tokai! Maddox exhausted her supply again, as she told the woman time and again to order in bulk. I did, but she never listens. Hold your chocobos, friend. The next batch will be ready before long. Why would I want a silver wrestler? Oh, well, but since it's useless, I might as well get it, because it might not be useless later. Quest complete. Alright, hey, I leveled up! I keep stock of secret spices. What gives my Munto sauce its distinctive punch, you ask? A perilla leaf, a dried dagon pepper, and anze of shroud pepper. Just toss all three in the gill. Fat and Geoffrey will take care of the rest. Guess I'm making some food. Shroud pepper. All right. Definitely sounds interesting. The other one around here? Am I losing my mind? Oh, there it is. Alright. Hello there. Apprenticing the cellars for the day. Very well, then. One perilla leaf, one dried dragon pepper, and an ounce of shroud pepper, and Aramont's done. Aramont's done it again. As thanks for your help, this bottle is on the house. Okay. Yay. That's it for these side quests. Cool. Well, not entirely, I guess. Hey, he gave that to me. You didn't do nothing. Crumpet, 30 minutes, vitality, speed, and piety. Skill, speed, determination. Alright. There's one in here that increases my experience. I don't know. Oh well. What is that? Oh, I have a cat minion. I forgot how to open my minion list. Spend energy stored in your party's limit gauge to execute powerful attacks. Okay, that's cool. Jobs, traits, main cans, pets. Wait. Oh, those are the higher level ones. Okay. No, I want to find where my minions are. Duty. Log. Social. Party. Travel. System. Character. Mount guide. Companion. I haven't looked at that one yet. Damn, if I could only remember stuff. Apparently I can summon him with Geisha. Okay, so a leafy vegetable indigenous to the Near East. While too bitter for most people's taste, chocobos are known to enjoy the flavor. This. And thus, the greens are often used as fodder. Okay. That's kind of cool. Alright, let's... What's a kitty look like? Oh, I have a kitty. Cool. All right, I like that. That makes me happy. Oh, but he disappears when I get on Chocobo. Alright, time to get this out of the way. Oh, come on, I'm trying to do something. Quit attacking me, you bastards. By order of the Elder Seer of the dungeon known as Thousand Maws of Totorak has been placed under control of... What? The Sylph Elders inside? And you're sure of this? How in the seven hells did he manage to sneak by? God strike me down for a purblind fool. You must find the Sylph Elder before he falls prey to the fiends within. Entrance to Toko Ron is ordinarily restricted, but these are exceptional circumstances. Assemble a rescue party, and enter as soon as you are ready. Got some kind of fire thing, huh? Minion of light. I gently pet the minion of light. Alright, so I guess. Duty finder. Okay. Average wait time 17 minutes. Goodness me. That's a long time. Alright. Well. I guess I could figure out which server I'm on. Well, this is odd. Character profiles are always public. Manage your service. Wonder. Okay. You log in the game tomorrow morning. Log in to the official forums and choose a character to represent your account. That will show you. That's what I just did. Okay, so. Does not show me. It does not show me. What is Matus? What is that? What is Matus? I don't know. We're gonna find out. Alright, so what I'm looking for. Ropers, role players. Okay. Best server. Minute wait, well, okay. ERP. Using terms that I don't know. Looking to see why everybody hates the Balmong server. Oh, erotic roleplay. Forced to be a part of it. When I was on Behemoth, I made a post, just like yours. It's from that LS, I was sent a tell saying that they have a roleplaying LS focused on business, specifically a tavern, and I asked if I was made until I travel. Decided to go off of Behemoth after some stupid things that someone put in me. This doesn't make sense to me. It seems that... Sorry, everybody. I know it's taken a while. I'm just trying to bide my time while waiting to start the battle. Hey, there we go. All right. Let us begin the dungeon. The 1,000 maw of total rock. All right. Oh, crap. Hold on, guys. Sorry. I'm trying to do something and I can't do it. There we go. Okay, here we go. Cool. All right, let's try this. Dude, decide which fucking target you want. Quit doing that. Side on a target and stay with it, damn it. I don't know what she's talking about. I hope she's not talking to me. fuck are you doing, man? Are you serious? Seriously? I don't know what you're doing. Like, I can't even... And now you're just gonna stand there. Oh, great. Where the fuck are you going? Alright, there we go. Alright. I don't even know who you're attacking. Uh-oh, who is this?
darkness.
Elkor Hitra Buglo Hans.
Comes now to me. With a countenance that bespeaks understanding, intriguing power, the echo, I must needs choose my words with care.
Mayhap I might disdain to speak in my guest cruel tongue. We meet at last. I am Lahabrea of the Asians, servant to the one true god. Yours is a most fantastical tale, truly absorbing. It is a tale to tell Eorzea's children before bedtime, and it will soon be dark, bringer of light.
The dark minions.
All that stands between this world and darkness is an irksome anomaly in the ether. The echo. Yes, yours is a most fascinating tale. Alas, like all good tales, it must needs come to an end. But fear not.
Hear, feel the presence of evil.
For the end of your tale is but the beginning of another. The tale of the crystal's demise.
Oh, well, I guess they started without me. Alright, whatever. I like watching cutscenes. Sorry, bastards. Oh well, whatever. I wanted to fight the boss, but they didn't want me. Or they wanted to... I guess they're just trying to run through. The reasons I stopped playing Elder Scrolls Online were because of people like that. People that like to bypass the story and just keep going for all the gruff. Finally, fresh air. Mayhap not so fresh, but better than before. Ah, sinister one is gone. This one can leave this awful place. Did Walking One vanquish the many-legged one? This one is grateful to Walking One. This one is called Phryxio, eldest of these ones, of little solace. Ew, I got a vision. Alpha Squad reporting, sir. Nothing of note at Larksaw. Understood. Return to Area 12. Damn it all. Where is the accursed Elkin? Icon? Icon hiding. No sign of our wizened friend, huh? I'm afraid not. Shall I order that the search perimeter be expanded? Absolutely not. We risking altering the Gridanians to our presence. Alerting! We risk alerting the Gridanians to our presence. His Excellency bid us avoid unnecessary confrontation. Loath though I am not, I am to admit it, I have found no evidence to suggest that Rama will be gracing the mortal realm in the near future. I ask you, what good is a god who does not grant one's wishes? Were I a sylph, I should strongly consider finding myself another idol. Which reminds me, what are the sylphs we captured? A handful of them seemed to be in reasonably good health when I last looked. Apologies, my lord. I fear we may have been overzealous in our efforts to compel them to summon their Icon. Really, Centurion? Were you not that vegetables bruise easily? Were you not aware that vegetables bruise easily? It is well that I did not trust you with the important task of making my dinner. Well, mayhap it was kindness. Better dead in truth than dead to one's own god, I suppose, if you believe in such things. Dawn is upon us. Make ready to withdraw. Guardians. Useless. We are so close to completion. I can fair taste it, but at this rate... No, I must be patient. Our efforts will bear fruit in due time. What was it you always said? Ah, yes. Though it mean bringing down very heavens, we shall challenge the limit of possibility if not we. And that alone. Were you right, Garland? But your star is long fallen, while mine both doth begin to rise. And it shall burn so bright that Lord von Balzer's ultimate weapon will seem a mere candle beside it. Those walking ones did for Noxia. This one is certain of it. This one fears that other taken ones also suffered the same fate. This one is convinced. Walking ones have black hearts, seek only to harm these ones. Walking ones are not to be trusted. Now, now, Noxia, do not pass judgment too hastily. Not all walking ones are alike. Though there are evil ones among the walking ones, there are good ones also. Does walking one feel unwell? This one would know what brings walking one to this place. Came to this one's rescue at Noroxia's bidding, then this one's walking one a debt of gratitude. Walking one has questions about Lord Rama, then this one will provide answers. But first, let these ones quit this listless place. This one will return to Little Solace when walking one is ready. Please come and see this one. These ones may speak properly then. Then it is settled. Let this company walking one outside. Yay! Alright. Where's my cat? Yay, my kitty! Alright. Ah, you're back. Tell me the Sylphelder's well. Thank the gods for that. I don't rightly know what to make of the rest of your tale, but I'm full glad Phrixio didn't come to any harm. Ah, but there I go. Tempting fate, run over to the Little Solace and secure us peace with the Sylphs before aught else befalls us, eh? Rest assured, I'll send word to our friends of Charlelin and the Twin Aider both. You've done Gridania a great service for this day, lad, and earned yourself a place of honor here at Druther's in so doing. Be sure and come by whenever you feel like a drop of quick grown fire water. You still have more for me to do? I've gotta go. I don't want to be here anymore. Say, friend, there's something I'd like to ask you to see to deliver to the Sylphs of Little Solace. This is Azima Rose Oil. It's a gift to celebrate the safe return of their tribe's elders and a token of Gridania's desire to unite. The wood is not what it once was. The calamity changed the elementals, weakened them. Until their strength is returned, we must lend them ours to keep wood safe. But ours alone will not be enough. We must have the strengths of the Sylph as well. Only by working together and fighting together will we survive together, and dwells wood with us. The gift I ask you to bear is a symbol of the hope that both Gridania and the Sylph alike will live to see the light beyond the darkness. What do you want now? Oh no, I don't want to play a game with you. You're back, lad, and something tells me you've not come for a flagon of Buskaren's ale. All the better that. I just overheard some Garlean stragglers was seen in Twelve's Wood, and you know, they're not like to be up to any good. Me? Why, I'd like nothing more than to get those Imperial War Swords myself, but I fear I've other duties to attend to this day. We're counting on you, lad. Okay. Oh, stormy weather. Investigate the specified locations. I am investigating. My investigation leads me to conclude that there is nothing worth investigating. Waiting. Alright, one more day. Okay. Oh, the other one's under the bridge. This is odd. There we go. Okay. Now I can get out of this place finally. Yay, okay. Now, deliver Harboring to... Oh, that's the fish thing. I do need to go back and check out that class and do some quests in it. I should be in South Shroud, so I need to go to East Shroud. Got it. Which means... I need to go all the way over there again. Hopefully that'll finish my questing here in Gridania. And I'll be able to go back to Limsa Lamenza. And that way I can switch over my class to my fishing class and hopefully do some quests there. Oh, that's weird. Okay. Those stairs led nowhere! Okay. I need to attune myself with that crystal before I go see the sylphs. Looks like their village is becoming available to me in this round. Hey, delivery mogul! I have something that was delivered! There we go! Alright! Now, thank you for playing Final Fantasy XIV. Enclosed with Wind Up, Riku Minion, and Fortress. May they help you forget the echoes of Tidus's maniacal laughter, if that's even possible. Take all. Yes. Alright, let's see this stuff. A slip of what appears to be parchment containing what appears to be some sort of feigned foreign script. Alright, let's see my little Riku minion. I'm not exactly sure how to redeem that item yet, but we'll figure it out later. Okay. Hey, it's Riku! That's cool. I still like my kitty better, though. There he is. Okay. Alright, maps up. On the Chocobo. Gift from Walking One Buskern, a gift for these ones. Such a lovely scent, this one has never smelled anything like this before. Walking One Buskern and Venturing One are very kind. I know that this one is deeply grateful. Many Walking Ones are scary, many Walking Ones utter many lies and much deception, but this one is moved. Let all these ones be friends forever. Adventuring One saved Elder, but this one must ask a favor first. Will Adventuring One bring 3 bottles of fresh blood? Is morbid favor, this one knows, but must have fresh blood from Vile One, known as Gigas. Here, Adventuring One, take blood bottles. Use it on almost dead Vile. Alright, so.
Getting sleepy here.
This one has been expecting Walking One. This one fetches Elder One. This one is pleased to see Walking One again. Welcome to the home of these ones. When all the work's done, you guys show up, of course. Ah, there you are, Catastrophe. We have just been hearing tell of your deeds of daring do. Well done. Ah, the Walking Ones who aided Naroxia. This one is grateful. A pleasure to have been of service. If you do not mind my asking, how did your misadventure come about? This one does not mind. The misadventures, as Walking One calls them, of this one began when Imperial once entered the wood. Fearing trouble, these ones decided to watch Imperials closely. But these ones watched too closely, and Imperial ones noticed and tried to catch these ones. Having nowhere else to hide, this one fled into Totorok. Would that this one had not? In Totorok, a sinister one robed in black, tried to feed this one to a many-legged one. Sinister one robed in black? Why do I have a feeling I should be more worried about that than I am? Elder Phryxia, we come to you as emissaries of the nation of Gridania. This missive bears the words of the Elder Seer. This one sees. So Walking Ones of Gridania are fearful of Lord Rama. Plainly put, yes, the people summoned the Lord Livin, but once, yet that single occurrence occasioned great alarm. But it's not as if the Gridanians dislike you or anything. Actually, it's just the opposite. They think of you as friends, and they don't want anything to get in the way of that. That's why the Elder Seer wrote to you. This one knows and respects. Horned One, Kani-sana, be assured. Like Walking Ones of Gridania, these ones have no desire for conflict. These ones resorted to summoning Lord Rama to protect the wood from the Imperial Ones. This one counseled against doing so, but was not heeded. Against this one's wishes, Lord Rama was summoned, and all those who took part became touched ones. These ones went so desperately to turn touched ones back to normal ones, but did not know how, and still do not know. touch ones, meanwhile, wanted to turn these ones into touch ones, and didn't know how. So this one fled to Little Solace, with all those ones who did not wish to be bound to Lord Rama. But walking ones of Gridania need not fear touched ones or Lord Rama. Unlike other primal ones, Lord Rama is not callous and cruel. So long as walking ones do not trespass on these ones' ancestral homeland, where touched ones reside, walking ones will not suffer thunderous judgment. But this one spoken enough of touched ones. This one would seek instead these ones. As this one said, these ones desire peace and walking ones of with walking ones of Gridania. And so, these ones ask for a chance to set things right. By way of addendum, mortals are tempered, come to take on qualities embodied by the primal in question. In the case of the Celts, Rama's influence has made them fiercely protective of their homeland. That explains why they're so hostile towards trespassers. But what about the abductions? A fine question, Ida. The abductions are, I believe, an expression of the tempered self's desire for reconciliation, another quality traditionally associated with Rama. In the crudest manner imaginable, they seek to bring their fellows back into the fold. A timely reminder that the challenges posed by each primal are unique. Elder Frixio, we thank you for making your will known to us. The people of Gridania will rest easier in the knowledge that they and the Sylphs are united in their desire for peace. Wishing to cooperate, this one has written down the feelings of these ones. Please see that these feelings are conveyed to a horned one, Kani-san. And with that, I believe we can lay the matter of Rama at rest. The Sylph's Elder is very reasonable, I must say. You could learn a lot from him. Was that a jibe? If so, I feel it's only fair to observe that one of us wouldn't recognize reason if it punched her in the nose. Did I say fair? I meant reasonable. Anyway, we're going to head back to the Waking Sands and tell Menphilia all about it. Fear not, we will be sure to mention the instrumental part you played in all of this. And while we see to that, we should appreciate if you would deliver Frixio's missive to the Aider's Nest. Elder Frixio, we humbly thank you for your time. It has been an honor. The honor is this one's. Together, let the walking ones of Gridania and the ones we find a way to live in peace. Please wait, Walking One Catastrophe. This one has yet to give Walking One a token of his appreciation. When these ones summoned Lord Rama, these ones were gifted this crystal. This one would now bestow the crystal upon Walking One as a symbol of these ones' trust. One more crystal. Is there sort of supposed to be a sound right here? Well, that's weird. This one was not mistaken about Walking One. Walking One is destined to walk a fate far crueler than this one can imagine. A brilliant light from within Walking One enveloped the crystal this one saw. Mark this one well. That crystal will one day be of use to Walking One. Walking One must keep that crystal safe at all times. Before Walking One returns to Gridania, this one would ask Walking One to watch Touched Ones. So long as Touched Ones are not troubled, Touched Ones will not make trouble. If Walking One witnesses Touched Ones making no trouble, mayhap Walking One can testify to Walking Ones of Gridania that these ones mean no harm. These ones' homeland is fraught with danger. This one's marks down safe places to look out for Touched Ones. About damn time. Alright. Okay, so... Alright, so that means I just need to go up here. And stand guard. Wow, that's a level 40 zone. There we go. They're a tempered sylph in the distance. You do not sense that they pose danger if left alone. Well, good. Alright. This one's the last one. Oh, goodness. Now they got me doing it. Alright. Okay. So. Just need to get these vials, and then I can get out of Gridania. Get out of the block shroud. Finally. Hopefully. Of course. Got it, okay. Go. All right, one down. 2! Oh, oh, there we go. 3 and done. Not too much longer and I'll be level 30. I don't believe. I've only got one more area to clear. Yeah, I think so. I think there's only one left. Before I actually start getting into the main story with cutscenes and stuff. Oh goodness, don't lag. Oh, come on, it's right here. I don't want to fight you. There we go. He knows when to give up. Alright, that's it. I'm done with you, Sylphs. Forever. Yes, you can have that. Keep it. No, I don't want anything to do with anything else. Gave me a belt I can't wear. Wonderful. Okay, cool. Now let's get the heck out of here. No, we're gonna teleport to Cordania. Okay, cool. Now, let's see here. There it is. The end of my journeys through Cordania for the moment. Until I hit level 40 and go back to the Sylph's territory. Ah, if it isn't catastrophe, how went the meeting with the Sylphs? Dude, it was not a meeting. It was a journey. It was like a trip. Alright. A missive from Sylph Elder himself, if I may. So, the Sylphs have no desire for conflict, nor do they intend to summon Rama. And so long as we leave the Tempered Ones be, we do not fear any aggression on their part. Elder Seedseer will be overjoyed to hear that the Sylphs have welcomed our overtures. And in the knowledge that they bear us no ill will, we may channel our resources towards the tackling the more conspicuous threats to our security. You have done this nation a great service, my friend. On behalf of all Cordanians, I give you my thanks. The Sylphic folk have long been friends to Cordania. The mere thought of being at war with them pained the Elder Seedseer to no end, but owing to your efforts, she will be able to rest easier. Being the benevolent soul that she is, my lady will surely try to find a way to reverse the tempering process. Once again, I thank you. Had the Scions of the Seventh Dawn not offered to mediate between our people, suspicion and doubt may well have led us into needless conflict. Pray, pass my regards to Lady Minfilia. And there she is. Hello? Hello, Catastrophe, can you hear me? It is I, Minfilia. Gita and Paplimo returned some little while ago. They wasted no time in regaling me with a tale of your exploits. Thanks in large part to you, the name of one primal may be struck from our list of enemies, and the Gridanians may turn their attention to more pressing matters. Well done! Yet the end of one tale is but the start of another. Pray return to Waking Sands at your earliest convenience. I would apprise you of the present situation in person. Fine. As long as it gets me out of here, I'll go anywhere. Alright. Northeast. Alright. I believe this is the right area. Ah, perfect! I was so right. Dinner's here, all right, let's see. Oh, I have to talk to you? I don't want to talk to you. Fine. Well, if it isn't my favorite adventure, welcome back, Catastrophe. Lady Minfilia awaits you within the solar. Please enter at your leisure. I am given to understand that the matter of Rama has finally been resolved. I fear resolve bespeaks a permanence we cannot rightly claim, yet I am well satisfied that Lord of Levin will not trouble us in the foreseeable future. Your satisfaction is assurance enough for me. How fares the investigation? Well enough. Thancred is sparing no effort. They are many in one, just as you suspected. Their purpose, however, eludes us still. I see. I've been meaning to ask, but is Alice Lise quite well? I feel as if I have scarcely seen her in recent days. Oh, you haven't, nor have I, alas. Elise has chosen to walk her own path, stubborn girl, but you may be assured that our destination remains the same. And on that note, I take my leave of you. I trust the Baldesian report will serve you well. I take it we can proceed as we discussed? Why do you ask? You scarce need my permission to act. It's good to see you again, Catastrophe. I've been looking forward to congratulating you on your triumph in the Twelves Wood. Owing to your efforts, conflict has been averted. Truly, you have done the Scions proud. With that, we can strike Rama from the list. So who's next? The Sahagin or the Leviathan? Lord of Worl has not answered his minions' call of late, nor is he expected to do so in the near future. While the Sahagin remains as aggressive as ever, they lack the quantity of crystals required to call forth their god. As with the Sylphs, we can leave them to their own devices for a time at least. For a time, bears repeating, we can ill afford to grow complacent. It is as Ystola says, unless we know the minds of the beast tribes, we cannot predict with any certainty when the next primal will return to plague the land. This being the case, we must proceed with as much haste as prudence will allow us. Any word of Titan? Maelstrom keeps the kobolds under constant observation. We shall hear from them ere long. You may depend upon it. Indeed, so then, of all the known primals that have been active in recent times, we are left with... Gridanyo! Wait, I meant Garuda, who is the primal of the Ixal who live near Gridanyo. Yes, that's what I meant. So many moms to cover. With that, there... were more efficient way to conduct our surveys. Where he's still with us, we should not long have wanted for a practical solution. She's not wrong. Where in the world are you, Chief? But one sure step at a time. Henceforth, the Order of Twin Aether will handle all matters pertaining to the Sylphs under the sage guidance of the Seed Seer. I bid you all enjoy a moment respite while you have earned it. There's something else, Catastrophe. Beg pardon. A man named Lahabri, spotting a red mass in robed in black? 12. Preserve. Prior to the calamity, the Essenes took great pains to remain hidden. Why would they choose to cast off their veil of secrecy now? Gods, this bodes ill. We must take advantage of the present lull in primal hostilities and investigate this Lahabra. Learn all we can of him and his designs. I dread to Eek! Alright. At long last, this one finds Walking One Catastrophe. This one is most dependable of these ones, is sent by Elder One from Ixio to help Walking Ones. This one is called Naraxia. This one comes as a friend. Let these ones be friends. But pleasure to meet you, Naraxia. Oh, another companion. Yes, pray do not concern yourself with my welfare. My current investigation has yielded some curious results, and at present I am pondering how best to proceed. Okay, whatever. Yes, Tataru is ready to express her fright as she is to express everything else. Not all of us are forged as the same steel as you, I'm afraid. But it takes all kinds of to make a family, and it pleases me to no end. The CRs continue to grow. One by one, the people of Eorzea are beginning to unite catastrophe, drawn to the hope that shines within you. Yet a darkness threatens to engulf this light. Never have I doubted the Ashian's presence, but that they have grown so brazen as to carry out their work in plain sight fills me with a sense of deep foreboding. I'm afraid there is no rest for the weary catastrophe, and we must delve further into the motivations of a masked man, the Ashian, known as Lahabre. This is an ideal moment to do so, while our hands are not bound dealing with another primal. At present, we know little and less about the Ashians, only that destruction follows in their wake. I should not be surprised if these beings are behind the chaos that wracks the realm. If my fears prove to be reality, we must do all in our power to stop them. Earlier, I said word to each grand company to solicit cooperation. The immortal flames responded to the effect that they have information on potential sighting. This is intelligence that we can ill afford to ignore. Go speak with Flame Commander Swift at the Hall of Flames in Ulduar to inquire further how you go about the investigation afterwards. Thereafter, I leave wholly to your discretion. But whatever you do, never forget that we are dealing with the unknown. You cannot take too many precautions. Be safe, Catastrophe. Alright, there it is. Now I've just got to do a little bit of scouring on how to reclaim my item. Oh, I forgot what it was. Let's see here. Dream of the Faith. That's a cool name, too. Because of the Final Fantasy 10. I don't know. I'll have to figure it out later. I don't know. Alright, well, that's it for me tonight, guys. Thanks again for coming by and watching. I enjoy your company, always. Always have a nice to have presence. And as always, I've got a long week ahead of me, so I'll see you guys next time. Have a good night.